गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप एवरीवन इज गुड एंड सेफ एट होम, राइट? सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द लेसन 4, द जेंट मिरर ऑफ राजकोट. ओके, सो इट इज अ टूरिस्ट प्लेस एंड बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द लेसन कंटिन्यूएशन पार्ट, जस्ट आई वुड लाइक टू रिपीट व्हाट we discussed in the last class. So it is a place located, okay, it's a mountain place, and this is a place, the visiting place of this thing will be October to March. Okay, so it is a mountain place located in southwest. Okay, and this place has a population, okay, and around 3,400 only, okay, population, and it has having a small industry town, okay. Then this place is called as a smoking waterfall, the tourist destination. And it is a electricity produce house plant, we can say. And in this area, there is no sunlight for 5 to 6 months. So this much we read in the last class. Now see what is the next part. On 31st October in 1913, a local newspaper published a suggestions by local bookkeepers Oscar Kittleson to use the solfil, means a sun mirror, to reflect sunlight, suggestions by local bookkeepers on this town. By technological limitations of the early 1990s stood in the way of the project. Instead, a cable car was installed in 1928 that made the trip up the sunlit mountain easier. What happened in the year 1913, it has given in the local newspaper published suggesting that so there should be a mirror reflection, means sunlight mirror reflection on the town, but there was a technical limitations. Because of this, once in the year 1990, I stood up with a new project. Instead of mirror, the cable car was installed in the year 1920, means after 28 years, that made trip upon the sunlit mountains easier. Almost 80 years later, okay, now means after 1928, almost 80 years later, the project was reviewed by the artist called Martin Anderson. In the year 2005, he launched the mirror project and worked towards both raising fund and interest in the project. A company that builds mirror system for solar thermal power plants is in hotter climates was drafted into the install the mirror on the mountain wall. So what happened now, you can see the picture in the above image, that after 80 years that project was revised, okay, reviewed by one more artist, that is Martin Anderson. In the year 2005 he launched the mirror project. Okay, now you can see the things in the picture above. Also I repeat, the mirror project and work together to raise the funds. Now for that projects there is a need of lot of money. For this, that person started contributing and raising funds and getting interest in the project, getting people involved, people should be involved in the work. And just he contained, he installed, means drafted, means he constructed, installed the mirrors on the mountain wall means in the high place he just installed the things. But this was not an easy task for as there were no roads leading to the construction site. Because it was too hills, it was hill station, it was too high place mountain. So, but the project was not so easy. So, as it says, but this was not an easy task as there was no roads leading to construction site, forcing them to carry the heavy equipments there by helicopter. And it is not always possible to take the heavy machineries, heavy equipments to the high place, and it means that it was not possible to bring all those things with the helicopter help. Since there was no way that could have hit heavy cranes up to the mountain, they had to improvise the maneuvers, the high mirrors in the place. So it was so trouble for the project and for heavy vehicles also, heavy cranes also. It was a big task for them. So here I just read once again. The surrounding mountains shed the town from the direct sunlight from 5 to 6 months of a year, making for a long cold winter for the residents. For many years, health conscious town people climbed up the mountain in the winter to bask in the sun and perhaps to stimulate their bodies to produce vitamin D. Rajkund was the company town of Norky Hydro, Norwing's company. It set up a fertilizer plant here to utilize the hydroelectricity that was generated from the waterfall. The founder of Nox Hydro, Sam, had wanted to bring it of nature light to the valley to cheer up the locals and make employees more active. On 31st October 1913, a local newspaper published suggestions by local bookkeeper Oscar Kittleson to use the solsif, means the sun mirror, to reflect sunlight onto town. But technology limitations of the early 1990s stood in the way of the project. Instead, a cable car was installed in the year 1928 that made a trip up the sunlight mountain easier. Almost 80 years later, the project was reviewed by that one more artist person, that is Martin Anderson. In the year 2005, he launched the mirror project and worked towards both raising funds and interest in the project. A company that builds mirror systems for solar thermal power plants in hotter climates was drafted in to install the mirror on the mountain wall. Okay, but this was not an easy task. So as the word saying that it was not that much easy to for this project. Because for this there is a need of heavy equipments, so and that cannot be taken, that cannot be carried through helicopter, and there was no proper road also to the mountain, means there was no, it was not possible for heavy cranes to take that big equipments on the mountain side. So it was a big task for the person. Now Joachim Maas, the CEO of appointed company, spoke about the ancient tool used, such as tripods made from wood over 9 meters long. The mirror were lifted and installed with technology that people used over a century ago. Now the CEO of the appointed company, okay, that he just planned, right, he gave an idea to follow the old tradition technology, that is taking wood, means plate, tree pads, okay, and it was, they built the constructed over 9 meters long, and the mirror were lifted and installed with the technology that people used over a century ago, means the old technology he was trying to adopt. Public criticisms too made the work a little difficult. So we know that for every good work there will be always a lot of disturbance. For doing wrong things there is no one to stop you. Like that, for doing this good work there was so much of words from the people, so that made this work to go little bit harder. Many in Russians throw a sun mirrors proposal was an expensive, okay, extravagant gimmick till the idea came to fractions. For them the cable car was the more durable propositions. Okay, so it was, for doing this one there was so much of disturbance, so much of words from the people, okay, and so for them it was the cable work, the cable car was easy for them, for the sunlight. But they are thinking that it was too expensive, and some people were saying that it is too difficult to me. And there may be some gossip, some maybe gimmicks. So means they are spending so much of money and they are taking unnecessary time, all those things. But the people were saying that cable car only was the durable for us. However, the minds behave this incredible innovations made it possible for the residents to experience the brightness and warmth of winter sun in their own town square. In the year 2013, that is 31st October 2013, exactly 100 years after the idea was conceived, the sun mirror became the reality. Yes, see my dear students, exactly on the 31st October 1930, a local newspaper suggested for doing this mirror reflection sunlights, and exactly 100 years after, means on 31st October 2013, exactly 100 years after the idea was conceived, the sun mirror become a reality. The sun mirror become a reality. So however, it's beautiful, no? However, the minds behave this incredible innovations made it possible for the resident to experience the brightness and warmth of the winter sun in their own town squares. On 31st October 2013, exactly 100 years after the idea was conceived, the sun mirror became a reality. 3 heliostars were erected on the right on the Gunstein Mountain, designed to shift every 10 seconds to track the movement of the sun. These heliostars are powered by renewable energy, solar and wind power. The mirror beam sunlights into the town's main squares, producing a beam of light at almost 80% of powerful as direction sunlight of the mountain, thus literally brings the city out of the shadow. Now 600 square meters of the earlier gloom's town's square is now flooded with the reflected sunlight. See, so it was a big contribution from the architect, from the engineers all, and almost 80% of this powerful light, okay, is getting benefited by, almost it is covered 600 square meters of the village is covered by the light. The sun mirrors have given a flip to both tourists and industries since they are a real draw during the winter. So means this project has given a real meaning to now. So it is now a appreciation from the tourist and the industrial people also, industries also. The town offers snow sports on the mountain and ice climbing in the local areas that lie around Rajgarh. See, with this power, with this sunlight, so they constructed, they offered in the town and for tourists also, okay, snow sports in the mountain and the ice climbing in the local area that lies around the things. For local people also it was available, and for the tourist people also it was available. The residents are thrilled to bits by the fact that people from all over the world now come to their doorstep just to see if the sun is shining. Even the critics are converted. Now see one thing I would like to say here, my dear students. So as I said, for every good work there will be almost always criticism. There is always people behind you to scold. There is always people behind you to tell so many words. Once you get succeeds, those critic people only come behind you or come before you and appreciate you a lot. So this is a lesson also, we can learn so many things here. So this after this, the snow sports mountain and the local people and the tourist people used to come and say, and people are eagerly coming to the home doorstep just to see sun is shining, even though critics are converted. In the word of Rajgarh's mayor, Stanis Barglid, it is a perfect combination of technology and art. Of course, it is a great welfare activity for the citizens of Rajgarh. So finally, ultimately, it is words from the mayor. He says that it is a perfect combination of technology and art, and of course it is a great welfare activity for the citizens of Rajgarh. So just friend, I would like to repeat the things once again. Okay, Joachim Maas, the CEO of the appointed company, spoke about the ancient tools used, such as tripods made from wood over 9 meters long. The mirrors were lifted and installed with technology that people used over a century ago. Public criticisms too made the work a little difficult. Many in Rajgarh saw the sun mirror proposal was an expensive, astringent gimmick. Till the idea came to fractions for them, the cable car was a more durable proportions. However, the minds behind this incredible innovations made it possible for the resident to experience the brightness and the warmth of the winter sun in their own town squares. On 31st October 2013, exactly 100 years after the idea was conceived, the sun mirror became a reality. 3 holisters were erected on the right of the Gormstrom mountain, designed to shift every 10 seconds to track the movements of the suns. These helistors are powered by renewable energy, solar and wind power. The mirror beam sunlights into the town's maintained squares, producing a beam of light of almost 80% of the powerful as direct sunlight on the mountain, thus literally bringing a city out to the shadow of now 600 square meters of the earlier gloomy town squares in now flooded with the reflected sunlight. The sun mirrors have given a flip to both tourists and industry since they are a real draw during the winter. The town offered now snow sports in the mountains and ice climbing in the local areas that lie around Rajgarh. The residents are thrilled to beat beats by the fact that people from all over the world now come to their doorstep just to see if the sun is shining. Even the critics are converted. In the world, Rajkund's mayor that says Steiner Barclay Land says it's a perfect combination of technology, art, technology and diet, and of course it is a great welfare activities for the citizens of Rajkund. So my dear students, it's very beautiful lessons. So it's very beautiful tourist place also. So thank you so much for being listen this lesson. And if possible, so we'll try to start in the next class, the next lesson. Okay. So soon I am going to send the questions for this lesson. So thank you so much. See you. Take care, all.